All right, new details. And, well, I'm going to get into the whole assassination attempt situation. But first, Trump introduced his economic plan and Trumponomics, which let's hope ends up working out a lot better than Bidenomics. Trump said, well, essentially, he's going to lower taxes, which is definitely a good thing in my opinion. He's going to lower taxes, he's going to lower the corporate tax rate to as low as 15%. Right now, I think it's around 21%. So he's going to try to encourage economic growth that way. He also talked about tariffs. He's going to continue the bilateral tariffs. He's going to keep Powell as the Fed chief until 2026. Gonna let him serve out his term. And he's talking about Jamie Dimon becoming the Treasury Secretary. Anyway. Well, he's also talking about deals. Now, this is a little bit separate from that. Deals in Ukraine. He's trying to work out a peace deal. He says that as soon as he gets elected, he's going to work to broker a deal. And I think if he does that, a lot of special interests are going to lose money because they were invested in this war in Ukraine. And a lot of people had a lot to lose if he were to become president. So there's a big concern there. And a lot of these people have strong ties to government agencies. They work with government agencies. But anyway, I'm not going to go there. the whole situation involving the shooting, I asked myself, who had motive and who had opportunity? I'm just going to ask that question. All right, so apparently, people are calling, public officials are calling for the director of the Secret Service, Kimberly Cheadle, to resign after that disastrous performance by the Secret Service in Butler, Pennsylvania, right? So she said that she wasn't going to blame local law enforcement, and the buck stops with her. She's not going to resign, of course. But yeah, the buck stops with her, because for a while it seems like they were playing the blame game, and people called them out on it. It's like people are blaming those female agents. Oh, those females shouldn't be guarding Trump. Okay, most presidents are at least 6 feet tall. So yeah, when it comes to when you want to create a shield, you want big men to create shields to protect the president. But I also don't like the fact, I still think you can utilize female agents. They can be undercover. They can still shoot a bad guy. And, men and women have different strengths. Men are much stronger, much bigger than women. So you utilize that strength. Now, for example, men are better at navigating for the most part, and women are better at remembering details. So you can still utilize the strengths of each gender. But anyway, I think it's funny how people just overlook the big question. And then people are sort of attacking these female Secret Service agents. I'm just thinking, like, do they plan the security at this event? Right? Because the real problem, the real failure, wasn't that, oh, some female agent wasn't able to holster her gun in a crisis. The real failure is that a 20-year-old was able to get onto a roof for an extended period of time, reportedly over 20 minutes, get set up and take shots at President Trump from only 150 yards away, 150 meters away. That's a real failure, the failure in planning. Why wasn't that roof secured? Why wasn't it secured? Well, according to the director of Secret Service, it wasn't secured because it wasn't safe. The angle of the roof was too steep. It wasn't safe for anybody to get on there. Okay, we have roofers in this country. They can make it work, anyway. And obviously the shooter made it work. Apparently there were actually counter snipers in that same building, but nobody was actually guarding the roof. It's the only building around, but anyway, I said that plenty of times. And now we're getting details about this 20-year-old, the gunman. Oh, wait, the FBI cracked his phone, but they don't have any, but we're not getting any information, right? They interviewed over 100 people, and they still haven't identified a motive. They should have had that set up already. I mean, they should have had the manifesto and everything set up to go along with their story. But anyway, the FBI, they're going to investigate. The House, they're saying they're going to investigate. course, we're being told that this is a security failure. The media, they don't even want to entertain a possibility that it's anything else. Like, I saw Representative Corey Mills, who was a sniper in the military, talking about the situation. He said that the situation needed to be investigated. They need to investigate all possibilities. Possibilities that it was intentional as far as the security performance. I mean, there are so many failures. But the lone wolf theory, it's always a lone wolf. No matter what happens, you know, it's never more than one person involved. Like, okay, sure. So, that's about all I have to say about this whole situation. I don't think we're ever going to learn the truth. I don't have any faith in the House of Representatives, the Republicans in the House. They won't do anything. Their investigations will lead nowhere. The FBI, they're definitely going to conclude it was a lone wolf, no matter what. That's what they're going to tell us. And, you know, there's not going to be any real accountability here. You know, so I'll just leave it alone. That's the country we live in. I apologize if I sound too pessimistic at times, but you know, I'm just used to being told that, you know, if you question a narrative, you're a conspiracy theorist. When COVID happened, people were saying that, oh, this was likely made in a lab. Those people were labeled a conspiracy theorist. We know how that turned out. Anyway, guys, have a good day. Take care of yourselves. Take care of your family. And don't forget the future belongs to those who prepare for today. Prepare for the future today.